This video was brought to you by GeneralPAC.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPAC. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Introduction to Electric Machines Part 1B. Application of Electric Machines in the Power System. Now this is the second part of Topic 1 in the series of Electric Machines. And in this part we will be discussing the different application of electric machines. And we will start with the use of AC machines, which consist of AC generators and AC motors. And this will be followed by the discussion on DC machines, which includes DC generators and motors. And the application will be easy for us to understand, and hopefully it will help us visualize their practical usefulness. So where are electric machines used? Now the answer is basically everywhere, from our households to industries and power plants of all sizes. Electric machines are a critical part of our lives, which without, many of our tasks would be impossible. We had previous discussions where there were two types of electrical machines, AC and DC. So now let's have a look at the practical applications of AC machines first. AC machines are two types. We have generators and motors. AC generators are a major source of electricity generation, and electrical utility generators and power plants generate electricity for us. And we all have seen backup and standby generators in our homes, in malls, restaurants, hospitals, and virtually all commercial places. These generators are known as synchronous generators or alternators. Another type of generator you should know about are induction or asynchronous generators, and they are mainly used in wind turbines. Now we will be discussing AC motors, which we have divided into two further types. We have induction and synchronous motors. Let's talk about induction motors first. Induction motors are used at almost every place that you can think of. Single-phase induction motors are used for small loads such as our household, for example, ceiling fans, water pumps, blow dryers, hand mixers, dryers, washing machines, even the motors inside our refrigerator compressors are induction motors. Now we will be discussing the very important three-phase induction motors widely used for industrial and commercial applications. These are basically the workhorse of an industry and have a range of application as feed water pumps for boilers, for HVAC system, air ventilation and exhaust fans, industrial fans and coolers, mixers, grinders, conveyor belts, hoists, elevators, cranes, carousels, centrifuges, fire pumps, elevators, winders, lathes, almost anything you can think of. Even food processing industries, paper printing machines, textile industries, oil and gas industries, and power generation plants, and the list goes on and on, and all of them use induction motors. Another type of AC motors is the AC synchronous motor. They are used for application where precise and constant speed is required. They are used in robot actuators, clocks, record player turntables. Also make use of synchronous motors. Synchronous motors are also used where high power loads at low speeds are required, such as a compressor, rolling mills, pulp grinder, reciprocating pumps, and so on. They are also used as synchronous condensers to improve the power factor of an electrical power system or the electric grid. That's all for AC machines. Now we will be talking about DC machines. And just like AC machines, we have two types of DC machines, the DC generators and the DC motors. Now let's continue to talk about DC generators. Earliest power system were DC system, however now they have been obviously replaced by AC systems. And now electricity generation was done by DC generators till about the late 1800s. But now DC generators are used in small power supplies and portable generators, for example, as power sources for standalone cellular telephone towers. Sometimes they are used to control speed and torque of motors used in lifts, cranes, trains, because of the DC generator stability in operation. Moreover, they are used as voltage regulators to make up for the voltage drop in DC distribution feeders, such as railways, and for adding voltage to the transmission line to compensate for the line drops. DC motors. Now, lastly, we will talk about DC motors, which are commonly used in our households. Toys, robotic vehicles, electric shavers, electric toothbrushes, all of them use DC motors. All your printers, hard disks, CD-ROMs, scanners, and photocopies and extract machines, these use DC motors. Small DC motors are mainly used as control devices, such as the tachometer generators for speed sensing and in servo motors for positioning and tracking. DC motors are also used in all medical equipment which needs small and precise movement of fluids, such as a dialysis machine. They also have industrial uses as steel rolling mill motors and railway traction motors. Even the power window in automobiles, car fans, starting motors in vehicles use DC motors. Brushless DC motors and brushed DC motors are used in electric machine, and it will be widely used in the future for the purpose as well. Now, so far, we have shared with you a lot of application of electric machines, and we hope that this video has served its purpose. The idea to discuss the application of machines before getting on to how they operate is necessary so that we may learn and we may relate what we're studying in real-life examples. You know, the electric machines are an essential part of our world, and most importantly, electric motors are used everywhere around us. And later when we're studying about these machines, we will already know where they will be used. Now, in our next video, we'll be discussing AC machines in detail, including the operation and working of an AC motors and generators. Thank you. We hope that you have a continued interest in this topic. And in this series, as either a student or professional, we also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to GeneralPAC.com and becoming our patron at patreon.com/GeneralPAC, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone everywhere. Thank you.